Logic's watch. This is Serpy. Now, South St. Andrew and its neighboring environs has produced some of the most dangerous young men Jamaica has ever seen. Today I'm going to be talking about another one. This one went by the name Bucky Marshall. Now, don't get him confused with the old-time Bucky Marshall from the Claudy Mashup days. But, you've heard me say it already, be careful some of the name them where you take on and pass on the line, because the younger Bucky Marshall, the one I'm going to be talking about, in terms of damage, in terms of things that he's done with his own hands, this youth was far more dangerous than the old-time Bucky Marshall. I have a couple names for you, just so you know. So this video, not gonna be no joke thing. Ice the Dancer, the LaRousse quadruple shooting, and Ramdale. Hope you have a cup of coffee, your Cersei tea, your Milo, your Alex, whatever you drink. But before I go any further, I have two public service announcements. Please stop sending me links in my DM of videos made by people supposedly dissing me. I am simply not interested in watching any of those videos. I have 999 problems, and extremely low IQ YouTubers ain't one. When the incident with Juana Parklin, most people pick up rounds and I'm trying to get intel, all I'm seeing flying in my DM is, Serpy, watch this, Serpy, watch this. No, I will not watch that. Okay. So, thanks, but no thanks. You can enjoy it though. Have fun. The next public service announcement, special birthday shout out to Sikrin, Patreon supporter. Big up yourself, bro, on a special day. Hope you have a great time. Hope you know you watch the video the same way. Right. Hope you have a good time with your family. You don't know, live long and prosper. Alright, big up. So, let me go straight into the video. Bucky Marshall. You've heard me talk about the Apex 87. If you don't know what the Apex 87 is, the video is on the channel. These are the type of individuals that have passed the point of no return. Bucky Marshall holds the unfortunate title of one of the many Apex 87, right, to come out of that part of Jamaica. Now, here's the thing with Bucky Marshall. Even if you've heard the name, you've probably never seen a picture of him. A matter of fact, one thing is common. Even people who know him, people who live in the community, seen him for years, have never seen him on picture, because he hardly take picture. So you know, say, some serious digging have to go on to get a picture like this. But Bucky Marshall was different from a typical 87 in terms of his mannerisms. See, Bucky Marshall was actually a nerdy 87. You know, Jamaicans call you a nerd, right, based on how you act, right, certain look of traits, certain look of things with your personality. Yes, he was actually, the way him behave, right, he was considered nerdy. You know them people who talk under them breath and go on at them can mash ants? That was Bucky Marshall. The problem was, he was one of the most dangerous youths to come out of that part of Jamaica. But the police didn't even know who they were up against. As me say, pictures were scarce. And the way him look, police would pull up on the corner, pick up everybody, and don't even look upon him. And he was probably the worst person upon the corner. To the point where even people who living at the era, none of them originally were in denial when they find out, say, he was a killer. People were saying, no, surely not. Bucky Marshall. Him? Because you know, in Jamaica, people judge you based on how you act. So if you screw up your face and walk, quote unquote, walk bad and talk bad and probably dress in a certain way, then you know, people say, oh, well, he's a bad man. But if you're generally more soft-spoken, then people say, oh, he's a man and a body. This a stereotype is what made enough people overlook Bucky Marshall initially until them find out that's how dangerous he actually was. man. And if you make things worse, you have a small frame. I'm telling you about them small frame 87s, eh? Them 10 times dangerous because them can't do nothing normal. Right? Them are come for you, them are for him to everything for you. So Bucky Marshall, Wally, top 87, Birdie, top 87. Right? The two of them use him for all the apps. You see, Bucky Marshall was one of them on the way. Just send him on the apps and him gone. Him no really need no about big money. Him no need no about big promises. Right? Once him say, are you a boss? Right? Then him go mash works for you. This make him highly rated, not just amongst his fellow 87s, but whether a Birdie apps him a go pan or a Wally apps him a go pan, them love Bucky Marshall. Just like how Klansman did love people like J-Bad, just say the word. Them don't need no whole type of explanation. Them don't need, because they have different type of 87s. You have some 87s where, for example, Nevada Hodges. In the other thing where, go for the Monday, then, hold on, what him do? Why? Okay, well, alright, yeah, I could go for him. But then, somebody like a J-Bad, or a bigger crime, is go for the Monday, and it's like, let's go. Then they need, if you know why, then just gone. Bucky Marshall just gone. Bucky Marshall could have locked off him owner 16. As a matter of fact, in the video I posted recently with a phone call with my name, I talked to Siva, Merman, Bunny. He didn't refer to the rifle as the Marshy. That's because that rifle, a Bucky Marshall like it. So much to the point that even though he's gone, the rifle literally named after him. Bucky Marshall, the type of 87 to also go pan ops by himself. There's an infamous case where he actually took out four people, right, by himself. Again, bearing in mind, he used to operate with an M16, and you know that guy already. Right? Somebody pull up on you, catch up on a corner with a rifle. Well, you better hope so you can run fast. Right? Because once you're in close proximity, by the time the rounds them start fly, you're probably not gonna know what happened to you. Right? People like Francis Lane also can tell you all about Bucky Marshall. Don't even bother try and count the amount of victims they have. Right? But I'm gonna tell you, some of the more high profile one name, and some of the more high profile cases. When you remember Ice? Ice the dancer? Ice the big dancer? Just as a refresher, look on your screen right now. That brother we are looking right now is one of the most talented dancers Jamaica ever produced. And I'm saying that with a straight face. David Alexander Smith, aka Ice. Now you remember, in 2008, Boxing Day, Ice lost his life. And people are saying, then, oh, Ice just dropped out, so. Especially after, you know, Bogle already passed on, people said, then Bogle gone and now Ice gone. What Ice could I do nobody? A lot of Jamaicans never know, see. Ice, the dancer Ice, was a full-fledged 87. Like, real 87. Guffy man, take my life, all of that. When the DJ did say, Ice should have reached long time because in bad behavior, that was a literal statement. It was Bucky Marshall who killed Ice. You see, you remember talk about Birdie from the Junker Nation, right? Birdie left a brother named Miguel. Ice played a role in Miguel's death. And you know the streets got ready. Man go defend it and man go, you know, get revenge and all kind of things. You see, Ice did even have parried Machine Man and all them at one point. He have other use like Skin Out, and yes, by the way, that Skin Out was a real 87. Like real 87 named Skin Out. Don't ask me. Right. Ice start parried man. Go pan him ops them, do him deeds them. Ice had a reputation in the streets as a shooter. But as me say, it just so happened that at the same time, he was stupidly talented. Now, I've seen enough dancers over the years. You know, Bogla the Godfather already for dancing in Jamaica. Over the years, enough youths that come from the dancing, I broke up on them, you know, bubble and all kind of big dancers. Jamaica produce enough dancers. Nowadays, they have ding dong on them. But I'm telling you this right now. Ice is one of the most talented dancers I've ever seen. For some reason, him just make it look easy. Ice make a thing say, you can just dance too, because him make it look so easy. But you see, Ice couldn't make up his mind. 1 minute, him want be 87. The next minute, him want turn dancer. But then, Ice, they already have a reputation, you know. Ice was known as a big dancer, but when Ice really go global, when Ice really turned in a big, big name, was the Gully Creeper. As you know, you see, he didn't even do it, right? A big track star, right? Big stage, the Gully Creeper, Ice boss, big time. Ice, people start booking him out, Ice the everywhere, everybody want him dance. Guess what happened? Ice start to forget, say he was 87. Ice start live like he was just a dancer. But me tell him, say, enough of my favorite stars in the entertainment industry. Right? Enough people who don't grow for no one love are real, real criminals. Ice, they all over the place, up and down, party every night. You see, when he was at 87, he live like a 87. But when time, Gully Creeper boss and everybody want a request Ice and one boxing day, that means December 26, 2008, I stop and I get cigarette. He must love the smoking. Guess who walked down upon him? Remember, you know, Miguel was Bird Brain brother. Bird Brain also have another brother named Jokey. Man, he walked down for Ice. Ice, remember me? Ice turned around. No, remind me of who, you know? Man, to Ice say, oh, alright, you remember him? I'm playing for Bucky Marshall. People, when I see Bucky Marshall, Ice try to take away himself because he know Bucky Marshall. Good, good. And he knows if and he see Bucky Marshall, he know what can happen next. Ice try to take away himself, but it was too late. Too late, and they mash up Ice, just like that. But Bucky Marshall mash up Ice. Remember telling about Skin Out? Well, how him lose film life, that probably deserved an entire video, because Netflix couldn't dream up nothing, right? Nothing like how Skin Out end up lose film life. So Bucky Marshall was the one who carried all the ups against Ice on the behalf of Bird Brain, because me say Ice them, right, did help get out in brother. So that's Ice. The next situation I'm gonna talk about, Bucky Marshall was involved for, is a case where to this day, a lot of Jamaicans, a lot of people, right, are convinced a police did responsible feat. Who remembers that case? When time the man in Gova, the venue where them they call LaRousse, and they end up changing name to Livewire. A brother named Bully, Ricardo Thomas. He was the owner of feet, right? You know, LaRousse was infamous back in the day. Beer foolishness used to go on at LaRousse. Right? British link up, keep venue, keep party and all, rounds gone all about the place. People are getting wet up left, right and center, because all of the top criminals used to go stand up at the same venue, and you know that guy ready. But when the four man in the job, LaRousse, Bully, in brother Kirk, right? Some people probably remember a brother named Mampy Zeeks from Augustown, remember him? Four of them total get mashed up. To this day, a lot of people are convinced a police do it. You know why? Because, well, the man them walk in like police. Full police uniform, vest, M16, everything. It was Bucky Marshall who led that operation. It wasn't police. Yes. Bucky Marshall them, they have them links. Where them used to get full police uniform, obviously from police. Vest, everything, and they would go up on them ups, go carry out them ups. And when them done, people say, a police did the shooting. Now, of course, police are still involved because when police give them their uniform, they never need to give them their rifle because they have their own rifle. They just need to give them the outfit. They know what they are use it to do. And this is separate from entire them peer corrupt cops to go do for them killing separate. You know? But the LaRousse incident, there's Bucky Marshall and man just applied police. It was too blatant to be real police. When real police are go pan corrupt up shooting, them they go like how the man them rolling pan them all the rules. It was very brawling, very ugly. You see, Bully and Waldy end up in a feed them issues because Bully did get blamed for killing Waldy father. Now at the time, I'm gonna tell you, Bucky Marshall was Birdie shooter, he was also Waldy shooter at one point. So Bully get blame for killing Waldy father, and Waldy then decides say they might get them revenge. And they say, you know, street thing already. It's answer the answer. You did this, you did that. Man, they go mash up Bully over his own business place. Bucky Marshall in the pull out a full police uniform. Just like how Stone Crusher them, bigger crime them, they have fit them corrupt cop links where them could get the full uniform, knock upon people door, police, people open the door, suicide police, and a bigger crime them. Well, them man used to do the same thing. To this day, enough people tell us a police actually carried out. It's Bucky Marshall. It's an infamous operation. Another case that Bucky Marshall was responsible for. When you remember the Ramdale shooting? Remember the father and the son? Well, you see, Bucky Marshall. I'm telling you, this youth, this list of victims is very long. There's Bucky Marshall who did one of the killings, but I feel like that deserves its own video. Feel like that Ramdale incident, the Ramdale shooting, deserve its own video. But let's know, say, Bucky Marshall played a role in it. And as you know, it was that same Ramdale shooting, you know, the son went first, then the father. That is what ended up cost Waldy's life. That Waldy case is probably the most recent example of what happened when a 90 octane forget them place in the system. One of the most recent examples of what happens when a 90 octane forgets even them of a boss, because Waldy was quickly cut down to size and people did say Waldy was untouchable. Because if you ever see Waldy convoy back in the day, you would have think that him are the Prime Minister. You'd have think that him them are called Brogad. Right, because when Waldy are move on, 3, 4, 5 vehicle, right? Buy out, he sometimes used to buy out police actors in bodyguard. But you see, once him take out the son, then him take out the father especially. You see, the son was one thing, but when him take out the father have some friends in very high places. Right? The father have some friends with 116s, and when a 90 violate 116s and upset 116s, well, you see, the 90 is quickly eradicated. People used to hype him up, right? Done of all done, I run off the wall of Kingston, the man can't touch. The man then wipe out Waldy, like where you step on a cockroach. And nothing will come out of it. One of the most brutal demonstrations of how badness really work at Jamaica. The 87 can get put in place by the 90. Now the body's 87 can get put in place by the 90, and the body's 90 can get put in place by 116. So even though the name Waldy is probably more known in the streets because of the high profile incident where him losing life, a Birdie, right, didn't know a start muscle out certain man to get certain things done, right, and take over the place. You know, couple key individuals that have lose them life so he could strengthen, right, his grip on the community, right? People like Houdini, right? You don't know 87 for the name already, right? CVM, right? I'm not talking about the news station, right? Marlon Brando, Tashai, all kind of people that have key individuals. Birdie that have to get them out, right? So him could have a stronger grip. And Bucky Marshall was a key figure. When him do them little apps and I get old people, Bucky Marshall name couldn't stop call. All the time in the dead, in the dead. Okay, you know, I saw them thing the guy ready. When the name hot, right? All if on a you go, a you go. Right. So Birdie end up start get stronger and stronger. Right? People are drop like fly. But you know it guy ready when it comes down to badness. Don't care who you be, right? Your time will come. Especially when you have as many victims, right, as Bucky Marshall. Well, him luck run out. Because the man them catch him lacking on the street. Normally, right, him always watch him head back in the really straight. Right, but you know it guy ready. At 87, like Bucky Marshall tend to get very confident. You know? So him go look for him girl, cause you know it guy already, you know the small head, right? Lead him on astray, him go look for him girl, don't check her, and then I go back home now, right? Casually walking upon the road like say him a normal civilian, right? The William Lane man them, right? Who knowing say Bucky Marshall was one of Birdie's top 87s, right? He was always upon them list because he was a major problem for them. So the man them end up ambushing him. And, well, it was a very, very grimy scene. As you can imagine, him go just like how him live. They had no mercy upon him at all. When they mash up Bucky Marshall, people were so surprised. Because, you know, when 87 build a reputation, you know, after a while, people start treat them like, say, them immortal. People start say, well, you know, look how much things him do. Police can't hold on upon him. 87s can't catch him. After a while, they start to get an ear of invincibility. And whenever the 87 start to believe this ear of invincibility, that's when, right, them days start to get numbered. My name mash up Bucky Marshall. To this day, people still lose them life back and forth for the Bucky Marshall thing. Right. To this day, Bird Brain them and Cuckoo them can't live good. Right. And the worst thing is, all of them money was friend at one point. You know, what I used to link at one point. And even the same girlfriend, Bucky Marshall old girl, Wingy, not long after he lost his life, close to the memorial, right, of his passing, she end up lose her life. Yes. But you see, if Bucky Marshall was alive and them killed she while Bucky Marshall was alive, South St. Andrew and its environs would end up roll a problem. Because based on how quick he was to go on operations, so things don't have nothing to do with him. If him did take it personal, if he could defend that girlfriend who him cherished so much, people that drop like fly. And even though Bucky Marshall wasn't around, your best belief say, man end up dead back for that girl. Right? Then they lay out one youth flat pan Constancing Road. Right? Fear. But that's another story. Same John Cronation. You see, enough people don't realize just how far and wide, right, the madness gone would tie straight back to John Cronation, you know. This is not those incidents will happen per Maxfield or another lane, you know. Enough for the communities, enough for the environs, you know, people are dropped. You know, and people are saying, well, what do I have to do with this? I don't understand. Well, it's not hard. Remember, 87s are mobile. Not because the man named B.S. a William Lane or them B.S. a Jim Road or them come from have a Maxfield or Cockburn. That means them just sit down there so, and they saloon them operate. Them left the community and go for man. And even when time them no go for the man them themselves, them have links so them can make deal with it. Sometimes all they take is a phone call. Yo, you don't know who just the stand up on bar. Yeah man, I him man, me sure. And them say, alright, deal with it. And just like that. So people are get caught lacking all over the place. There's a reason why South St. Andrew is number one in the entire country for murders. Think about that. South St. Andrew topped the list. Them topped the list this year and them topped the list last year. So you have to understand when I tell you that this is a place that produced some of the most dangerous 87s Jamaica ever see. But don't worry yourself. The first things that I'm going to talk about in this video, I'm going to just barely brush. The surface. There's going to be entire videos about them. For example, the Ramdale, my father and son. Because especially the son, the hit on him was, let's just say, well orchestrated. The father one was more simpler than catching him on his business place. Outside and business place on Beachwood Avenue, my boy. The Ramdale up a route van road, then catch him. A creeping at the traffic. When things are buck ups, when things them just accidentally buck up in him on the road, no. But that's going to be a whole separate video. So I'm going to leave this one just for now. Bucky Marshall. I make no exaggeration, let me say. One of the most dangerous youths, South St. Andrew and the neighboring communities. No matter of fact, the whole Jamaica has reproduced. But out of all the 87s I've covered, he's probably one of the most unconventional in terms of how he operates, his mannerisms, his behavior. The rest of them tend to be traditional 87s. People know, say, them bad, them look like them bad. If you just walk in the community and see them one time, you probably can come to a fair assessment so well that you tell the things. Bucky Marshall, apart from his eyes, because remember the eyes don't lie. But very few people, even got close enough to him to look into his eyes. He had the eyes of an apex citizen, but everything else about him was nerdy. Look like, say, he could just box him down, push him over. Those are the type of 87s you can't trust. You see, a 87 will shout and make a bag of noise. That's textbook 87. Easy for David. You see, the 87 will talk on their breath. Can barely hear him, I say. Like him, a whisper. My talk on a whole long head. And like him, can mash ants. Those ones are 10 times more dangerous. I'm going to leave this one just for now. Bird brain, I know you all listen. Because I know you tune in regular. Bonnie, right. Hold on and tune in. Keep tuning in. We have a mighty long way to go, as the song would say. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Bless.